All right, I'd like to welcome everybody to our monthly meeting of July 13th, 2021. Welcome. I'd like to start tonight with a pledge of allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, thank you. Start tonight with a roll call of officers.
Supervisor Von Albarico.
I am here.
Trustee Dean Morelli.
Here.
Trustee Greg Vickas.
Here.
Trustee Kieran Johnson.
Here.
Trustee Denise Salvito.
Here.
Assessor Mary Ann Williamson.
Here.
Highway Commissioner Jim Lausch.
Here.
Collector Sherry Williams.
Here.
Attorney Gary Mueller.
Present.
All right, thank you. Everybody should have in their packet the minutes of the Road and Bridge meeting of last month. I do need a motion to pass the minutes.
I'll make a motion to pass the minutes.
I have a motion by Greg Vickas.
I'll second.
Second by Denise Salvino. Any questions with the minutes? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it, thank you. You have the bills for the Highway Department at $60,810.97 for the month. I do need a motion to pay the bills.
I'll make a motion to pay the bills.
I have a motion by Greg Vickas.
I'll second motion to pay the bills.
Second by Denise Salvino. Any questions or bills? Hearing none, can I have a roll call, please?
Trustee Dean Morelli.
Yes.
Trustee Greg Vickas.
Yes.
Supervisor Albarico.
Yes.
Trustee Kieran Johnson.
Yes.
All right. Any citizens wishing to address the board for the Highway Department?
Trustee Denise Salvino, I'm sorry.
Yes.
You run the...
There's one short. I'm sorry, too. Any citizens wishing to address the board for the Highway? Seeing none, we'll run to Jim's report.
Thank you, Mr. Supervisor. Good evening, board. In addition to the regular summer road maintenance, drainage issue, potholes, tree branch pickup, and regular maintenance, the Highway Department will be advertising bids for the repaving project, on several township roads. The information for the bid will be printed in Herald News on July 14th, I think, the debt collector. After all the rain that they do, we also can work on many drainage issues with full kind of land use, forest clearing, we have to clear out some of the creeks so the water is flowing much better. We've identified some sidewalk replacements, property county, both giving some NFT monies and grants that will pay for some of those projects. And there are so many pictures I want to share with everybody just to show that the immediate concern is to have some of those sidewalks taken care of. Lastly, we have tire drive testing set for September where tires can be brought to Highway Department from all of the townships around the township and will then do a certified disposal grant. And that will be it for my report.
All right, one thing I want to ask, I did get some emails from the gym last week about that cleanup in Fairland. Is that set pretty well?
It sounds like it is. Fairland Community Group is, it sounds like, putting together and working with their residents throughout your program and project.
Just to make the board aware, I did, talk to the garbage company, Mumbles, and did sign off on letting them use the dumpster that are in the contract. We need two dumpsters in the contract for a year to do for that thing. I don't see any other reason to clean up the area for a new dumpster. All right, other than that, I have no other business unless somebody has a question about how it.
Did
know is, obviously, we're getting an email from the same landowner up in the Fairmont area. And one of them mentioned something about, the county had some type of stormwater committee or somebody that possibly might be able to lead us in a direction. I mean, I don't know what you read. Is that something we should maybe consider or...
Yeah.
And we...
In 2017, I believe they did a flood study. They started correcting some small mains and flooding and drainage issues. That got put on the back burner, you know, several reasons, COVID and prior to that also. So we had a meeting last week and we started picking up again. They've started talking with D3 construction and their focus started in the central area. You know about your mains and whatnot, identify the, hot spots they often have, but whether it's obstructed drain or caved in, and we'll work with them.
Thank you.
I believe the first phase is very complete, doesn't it?
Yeah.
The two-phase type of program.
They started like in the Fairmont School area, that northern area, and southern would be a green garden in Fairmont. And then the continuing third phase also to the south of it.
Alright. Any other questions for our panelists? Very good. I have nothing else in the pathway, so I'll ask for the adjournment.
I'm going to motion to adjourn.
Motion by Greg Biggs.
Second.
I'm sorry, I have to apologize again. I'll stay there for the new trustees. Just remind everybody that I have got them on here, so I can't tell which direction it comes from. I'm sorry, second by Jared. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? I see it. Thank you. Moving into general assistance, again, we've got the minutes of the June 8th, 2021 meeting in your packet. I do need a motion to approve the minutes.
I make a motion to approve the minutes.
A motion by Greg Biggs.
A second.
Second by Karen Johnson. Mm-hmm. Any questions or minutes? Hearing none, all in favor? Opposed? Exempt. Thank you. You have bills of $5,272.96. I do need a motion to pay the bills.
I'll make a motion to pay the bills.
Okay. Denise, Maureen.
Second.
Greg Biggs. Any questions on the bills? Hearing none, can I have a roll call, please?
Trustee Dean Morelli?
Yes.
Trustee Denise Salvino?
Yes.
Trustee Karen Johnson?
Yes.
Trustee Greg Biggs?
Yes.
Supervisor Alberico?
Yes. Who cares? Any citizen wishing to address the board for the general assistance tonight? Seeing none, I don't have any new business. The only thing I do have left is the monthly financial report. Again, we had one application, total application. We had about four new ones taken out, three weren't returned, one application was returned. We right now we have three that we qualified and no new cases and no emergency. I have nothing else unless anybody has a question. I'll let you in here.
Make motion to adjourn.
Motion to adjourn by Greg Biggs.
I'll second.
Carry on. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? I say it. Thank you. We'll be moving on to our senior fund. Again, in the packet, we have the meeting minutes of June 8th, 2021. We need a motion to pass minutes.
I'll make a motion to pass minutes.
I have a motion by Greg Biggs.
A second.
Second by Karen Johnson. Any questions in the minutes? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Aye, aye. We have bills, total bills, this is month, our senior fund, $37,356.26. We need a motion to pay the bills.
I'll make a motion to pay the bills.
I have a motion by Director Denise Solino.
Second.
Second by Director Pickles. Any questions for the bills? Our senior. Hearing none, can I have a roll call?
Supervisor Alberico.
Yes.
Trustee Dean Morelli.
Yes.
Trustee Greg Bickus.
Yes.
Trustee Karen Johnson.
Yes.
Trustee Denise Solino.
Yes.
Motion carries. Any citizens wishing to address the board for our senior fund? Hearing none, I don't believe I have any new business or old business. I do apologize, I don't have a transportation report this month. I would call, missed it this month. I'll do it over the next month, you know what a bus is about to. But the buses are, you know, out there every day, and the new buses are over. I have nothing else, I retain motion to adjourn unless there's a question.
We'll make motion to adjourn.
I have a motion by Director Pickles.
I'll second.
Second by Denise Solino. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Yes, yes, thank you. All right, town fund. Again, we have the minutes of the monthly meeting of June 8th. I think the motion to pay, pass the minutes.
I'll make that motion.
I have a motion by Karen Johnson.
Second.
Second by Greg Pickles. Any questions in the minutes for the monthly meeting of June 8th? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Yes, yes. Now, we do have the minutes also of the special meeting that we had on June 17th. And we need a motion to pass those minutes.
I'll make a motion.
I get a motion by Karen Johnson.
I'll second.
Second by Denise Solino. Any questions or those minutes? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Yes, yes. We have the bills for the senior for the town fund, I'm sorry, of $107,613.35. We need a motion to pay the bills.
I make a motion.
I have a motion by Karen Johnson.
Second.
Second by Greg Pickles. Any questions for the bills? Town. Hearing none, can I have a roll call, please?
Trustee Denise Solino.
Yes.
Supervisor Alberico.
Yes.
Trustee Dean Morelli.
Yes.
Trustee Greg Bickus.
Yes.
Trustee Karen Johnson.
Yes.
Okay, motion carries. We also have the bills for the water bills, $3,538.56. We need a motion to pay the bills.
I'll make a motion to pay those bills.
I have a motion by Greg Bickus.
I'll second.
Second by Karen Johnson. Any questions for the bills?
John, can I see you got two separate totals that came in. I guess my question is, I know we talked about putting a deadline on this. I mean, do you know if these were just recently received or if these have been on or if they're no?
I think they did. Yeah, I think they did come in. And the deadline was the end of last month.
Okay.
I think they did come in more than a month, so.
Yeah.
Totaling everything out, yeah.
Okay.
Any other questions? Can I have a roll call, please?
Supervisor Alberico.
Yes.
Trustee Greg Bickus.
Yes.
Trustee Karen Johnson.
Yes.
Trustee Denise Solino.
Yes.
Trustee Dean Morelli.
Yes.
Motion carries. Any citizen wishing to address the board here tonight? Hearing none, we will move on to the assessor's report.
Thank you.
Can we begin?
So, Will County Supervisor of Assessments will be mailing notices of revised assessments. They'll be dated August 11th, so I think they're going out a couple days ahead of that. The assessments will be published in the local newspapers on August 11th and 12th. Residents only receive a notice in the mail if there's been a change to their assessment that happened at the township level. So that means if you don't receive a notice, then as the assessor, I didn't make any changes to your assessed value. The Will County Board of Review appeal process begins on August 11th. The deadline to turn in an appeal is September 13th, 2021. Any taxpayer can appeal their assessment regardless of whether a change was made this year. So even if you don't get a notice in the mail, you can still appeal your assessed value. Please remember that you only appeal your 2021 assessed value. And then again, this year, the assessor's office is going to sponsor a trunk or treat. The date is Thursday, October 28th, between 5 and 8 p.m. It's been a lot of fun in the past. We've always had a pretty good turnout. We didn't have it last year because of the pandemic. There will be cars out in the parking lot with decorated trunks, ready to take some trunk or treat, and then we'll have games inside, and we're hoping we'll end up with a food truck. So the budget, the town fund has an item in the budget for $1,500. We've spent between $2,000 and $2,500 in the past couple of years. So some of that came out of the assessor's budget. Some of it also came out of employee's pockets. So I'm asking for an additional $1,000 to get to that $1,500.
Just to clarify that this $1,000 will come out of the practice. You want to make an event? We're positive that before has a decision. So I would ask for approval to appropriate up to $1,000 extra for the trunk or treat event.
I make a motion to approve the extra $1,000 for that event.
I second.
Any questions about the motion?
I would just request that we adjust the budget next year instead.
I'd like to make a note of that and you and I just need to do a level since make sure we raise that. We didn't do it last year, obviously, because of COVID. The years before, Debbie, when the assessor was doing it, she never requested anymore or thought that anymore. So I was unaware of that coming up the top. I had no issue.
Yeah.
Any other questions? Can I have a roll call, please?
Supervisor Alberico?
Yes.
Trustee Dean Morelli?
Yes.
Trustee Greg Vickas?
Yes.
Trustee Karen Johnson?
Yes.
Trustee Denise Salvino?
Yes.
Anything else?
That's it, thank you.
Moving on, we'll go to our clerk's report.
About that senior fees and all that, was that ever decided? I mean, did they have to apply for that this year or did they carry it out again?
So at this point, it's been passed through the legislature, and my understanding, I haven't checked in the last few days, my understanding is it's sitting on the governor's desk waiting to be signed. We don't see any reason why we won't sign it, and so we're just waiting for word that that's going to happen, and then that would roll over all the annual exemptions the same way it did last year, so people won't have to apply for veterans, senior freeze, or the disabled person exemption, if they get a freeze, it'll just roll over. We do always encourage people when you get your tax delivery year to always look at your exemptions to be sure that the exemptions you think you should be receiving are on your tax bill. The review at my level, the review at the county level, and then entered into the computer database. If there's an error, you can correct it. Have a limited amount of time to do that, so it is important to always check your exemptions out. but we anticipate that there will be any issue with those going over.
Yeah, without that, you residents require, and all, obviously, you said time would be an issue, you know, some reason it wasn't approved, and that quarter rush.
Right. Well, the other thing that county supervisor of assessments said, she had mailed out a postcard to everyone and said, if something happens and it's not passed, then they would mail out the forms. So it's kind of, you know, no news is good news. If you don't get a form in the mail, you can assume that it passed, and just be sure to check your tax bill next May 1st.
Any other questions for Carrie? Move on to our question, Carrie.
Okay, so during the past month in the clerk's office, we have been continuing to organize and establish all areas to reflect my new position as your clerk. My status as notary is now official. And each year, the clerk's office has kept up on record disposal, and currently, we have been preparing records for disposal in accordance with the Local Records Act. The clerk's office encourages all offices to do the same. Please review the attached sheets of the records disposal certificates to view the breakdown for the last submissions for each office. There's a couple of things to note from the Will County Clerk's Office. The 2022 general primary election date has changed to June 28th instead of March as previously expected. Additionally, the Will County Clerk's Office has announced the vital records electronic request forms that make it easier to request birth, marriage, and death certificates by completing a request form online. On July 8th, I received an email from State Senators John Connor and Meg Loughran Capel, and this was pertaining to the virtual job seeker workshop series. These online workshops, the first one was held today, but the next ones are coming up, and they're open to the public, and they're free of charge. For more information, you can contact the offices of the centers by phone or email. That's it.
All right. Thank you very much. Unless there's any questions, I will move on. The trustees or cabinets or suggestions?
Yeah, I have a question. So have these records been disposed of yet?
So we need to apply. And then they have to approve it, and they've already approved it for us. So we are in the process of gathering everything that needs to be disposed, and then we dispose it about a shredding date for just the clerks, and we do it, what is it, 2 months? The first day we can do it is 2 months from the date of when we originally submitted. So which is September 6th.
I'm seeing the sewer and water department receipts. Those invoices being displayed. I wondered we're still talking about records there. If you wanted to do that at this time, we're waiting until the end of the year or something like that.
Well, I don't know what we've already disposed of, obviously, from years past, but I don't know if we can explain that yet. All right, any other questions?
I had a question. In the minutes of state, we talked about last month, the letters being sent to former trustee and clerk, or the clerk that sent out.
We talked about it, and I did actually have a conversation with the attorney. Basically, I don't know if it's really that question. You're the one that has an issue, and you need to ask. The lawyer pretty much says that there is an issue. Residents, there's no way to prove it. They still have a board of DIV, they still have licenses here, as far as we're aware of how we can get in. Basically, it seems to be a personal issue, it appears to be a personal.
Well, I think if we just ask them, if all our residents, I'm asking to Department investigation. I could ask them, but they, maybe they weren't aware that they were supposed to receive that money. They weren't with me. They weren't aware of the meeting. Okay, well. I'm sure that on my, if I send them a letter, they're not going to respond to it, so that's your point at this point.
I guess I could copy the letter, they're not going to respond to me. Any other questions or comments?
I just want to say, I can't hear you guys completely very well when you turn that way. So if you can move your mic just a little closer, thank you.
All right, going into the building report. I will read the building report first. All right, the sign out front has been enlarged. We're having two more signs. We need two. One for the food pantry and one in the event that we do have veterans administration coming in. If they decide they want to put a little sign up in our front, I want to discuss that with them, everything goes according to plan tonight. But I did have that enlarged enough to hopefully it'll fit. We'll move out the high food gauge in there. The food gauge is signed about 4 inches smaller than theirs, and I'll have to have a feather probably about 3 or 4 inches smaller than that, and they'll all fit in there. Nice. Still looking for a maintenance person. We need someone with a general knowledge on simple repairs, fixing leaking pipes, faucet, changing the light bulb, that kind of stuff. Please call our office at 855-838-0380. I want to go back to that in a minute. Preparations are underway to host a play, Summer's Night Dream. This will take place on July 23rd, 24th, 25th. 30th and 31st, we met out for this event, and we show them support for theater. Let me know if you guys want tickets at the let Limestone know. August 3rd, we are starting, this is the new thing I want to start now, we know this with Marianne Short, Karen, and I'd like to put safety meetings together for all our employees. Once a month, just a 15-minute real quick meeting so everybody's aware of different situations like tornado warnings, fire drills, armed person coming into the building. I'd like to do this on the first Tuesday at 9 o'clock in the morning for 15 minutes. Seems like on Tuesday mornings, it's quieter in the building before anybody gets here, then we can get all the way down here or in that office. We'll have to put 15 minutes. So we're all on the same page. We're in the light. We've had experience with an accidental fire drill going off, fire alarms going off, and everybody kind of wanders around, not knowing what to do. There is a protocol that our building personnel and the public is supposed to do. So I think we need to just refresh that stuff.
So, what is the location that you're going to have that?
What's that?
What is the location where you're going to have
that? Probably down, right down here. Probably either one of the side rooms.
Okay.
It's a new project. I think we'll start it that way, and if it works out, we're doing it so it can change. If it's more convenient somewhere else, and they have a better idea, we'll most certainly change it around. Let's start on the first Tuesdays, in that first multi-purpose. That's all I have on the building report. I did want to go back really with this personal maintenance person. I did have a person apply who's a very qualified person. I'm very impressed with his ability. I would like to bring him on. He just worked in 3 days a week. The issue I have, and that's why I didn't bring it on, that I want to hear guys' opinion. Because I've been in this building long enough, a lot of employees. He wants $25 an hour. Very qualified. knows his stuff, but I don't want to take that out of myself and everybody come to me to help him, help him and thank him so much. He's poured it all behind us, so I'm asking your blessing, I need that seat.
Tom, did we, I know there was a discussion about coming up with a basic list of jobs, for maintenance.
We did put one together.
Okay.
And Aaron, actually Aaron did the bulk of the work done.
Okay. I guess I would ask, during his application, I mean, did he, check the boxes that he was capable of doing what we requested, or have you seen that, or?
I'm not aware of who this is just yet, it's just in the talking stages. So I did prepare, a job description for a maintenance position, a maintenance worker, and I'm not sure. I haven't been involved in that process.
Ron, did you figure out if this is gonna be a part-time, did you see them like,
He suggested part-time.
But I know, obviously it might be time, need emergency, see if he'll come in.
He would, he said $8 would be pretty personal. The only issue he did have is, he also, he's a retiring landscape person, he's a busy business and shutting down his business, so I know he would start to relax. He doesn't want to quit. He does have, does some snow plowing, and it still does that a little bit. And there might be a little issue with that. And when you try to work around that as best you can, you can have one of our bus drivers that comes around the flowering courts in the morning when he goes out on the route. He will, the new guy will be able to come out and plow whatever he can, if he's not here, you know. And then I also come out and plow. I'm trying to get it right. Yeah. You know, if, we bring this guy in, it's not hard to stone, see how it works out.
Right, I mean, would he have, set hours though, or would he be working?
Yeah, I would think it would be like Monday, Wednesday, and then, obviously, if something's going on in the building in the evening, it would be pretty good that the other day, this person, the custodian person, who wants to come in and back up, check. So.
Do you think there would be enough hours, an 8-hour shift in a Monday, Wednesday, Friday? Or would it be like 4-hour shifts? What do you think?
I'm kind of thinking maybe a shorter shift.
That's what I think too.
4 or 6 hours.
Right.
Yeah. Monday, Wednesday, Friday. I would like to, obviously, we have an ordinance in place that anything after 1,000 hours gets to the MRI, the mail, medical, and all that. I'd like to keep it at 1,000.
I think it's appropriate, given the maintenance that we already have that goes on at the building, it would be appropriate. Just would run into when the snow plowing, if you have another remarkable winter like we did, having to balance that, and when the priorities would be here, of course.
Well, with his landscaping experience, I can do some of the landscaping maintenance that we've done.
Oh, man, good. Yes.
Hey, but I have the important question we talked about. We're going to do another session.
Well, I guess I'm going to remain. Okay. I just basically want to know if you guys are comfortable. So we have to
do that. Okay, I just didn't want to. Yeah, I don't want to go to the whole session once again. As far as the qualifications, I didn't know the person that spoke about. General construction knowledge is very good. Does nice work and would be good to the position for the project.
All right. Anybody else have a comment? Do we need some server? Okay with it?
Yes.
You guys okay with it? Not begging down our door either.
I agree. It's very hard for people who are not applying for jobs on if you can actually get someone who comes in that's actually well qualified and can
frustrated with being the maintenance man, saving doors down and cutting doors, you know, doing all the work that we do.
When we do hire, we have a probation period.
Yeah, it's usually about 6 weeks.
And obviously background check and all that. I think with the job description, that would certainly.
Yeah, I think we could get somebody to understand.
All right, I'll take your advice.
So I agree with you, there's some experience.
What line item would you use for this, do you have, budget funds for this?
It's already in the budget.
Okay.
There's plenty of money that you pay that much amount, because of part time, we have the money.
Okay, sounds good.
Money's already between, split between town and city.
And he would be supervising other people too, right? Is that just making the?
He'll be meeting other staff.
Yes.
All right. Next on the agenda, under building report, I have three bids, three projects, I believe there are in here, for the lights. I've been telling you guys in the meeting that we have some issues with those candy lights in our entryway, half of them are out. 37 of them, and they're not just regular lights, also, got a weird, lobby of things, we have to get it changed, or fixed, or be in the dark. So I think it's four bids, one from two from one same company, I'm sorry, black. I think Elliott Electronics is the lowest bid. So I would, unless you guys don't feel you can use that, or don't want to fix the lights, I would suggest a motion to approve the Elliott Electronics bid.
I'll make a motion to approve Elliott Electronics for the bid.
$3,500.
I'll second the motion.
My motion by Dean Moran, second by Greg Pincus. Any questions on this?
One thing, one question I did have about it is, do the new LED lights fit in the same size that they have to be drywall repaired? I know, there's no drywall repaired in it, which I didn't understand.
It's all drop ceiling.
Okay, it's all drop ceiling, so we need to be able to move extra panels on it. Sounds good.
Hopefully, we'll make the place completely.
They're all in drop, so.
It's all in.
Okay.
Any other questions?
Yeah, I would just say there's such a big difference in the bids, just to confirm that there's not anything else that might need to be done that they didn't include, that's all inclusive and pretty clear.
Yeah, we'll look at it, of course, and make sure that, you know, once you have the sidewalk, that's what we need.
We need to confirm this, you know.
You know what, I've got to say that about the permit, I will have Michelle from city, and usually way off from this, I have a lot of chance.
Oh, yeah.
But if you have the right. All right, so I have a motion and a second, any other questions? We have a roll call, please.
Trustee Denise Salvino?
Yes.
Supervisor Alberico?
Yes.
Trustee Karen Johnson?
Yes.
Trustee Greg Pincus?
Yes.
Trustee Dean Morelli?
Yes. All right, motion carries. Moving on, another improvement on this building. As you know, every month we're have our meetings, and we're sharing mics and passing mics around because we don't have enough mics in this system that we put together. Trying to get the mics put together for a few years now, and it seems to always kind of fall to the wayside. Now, I do have two bids planned. One is from a company that originally put in the sound system, Vegas Communication, and one is from Lego Music and Dance Academy, the music store here in Lockport, the local guy. Tim, I know him, he does plays here. He does a lot of He sets up the sound system, all the lighting systems, he does it for a living, he put together a bid for it. Basically, we'll get eight new mics, then all the good things, we'll get four more of this hand, cable pack, we'll get a couple of lapel mics, in case someone's walking around with a program, and then we'll add one mic, a taller mic back. And the finish of the day, and then over the top of the podium, and maybe add a new players. But they do come and set the tape. So I would entertain a bid to accept the Allegro Music and Dance Academy's bid for the 8 bucks.
I'll make a motion to the bid for Allegro Music and Dance.
Motion by Greg Pickens.
I'll second it.
Second by Jerry Jensen. Any questions?
Does the Pace company also use this for the...
They have.
Yeah, okay, that's not a good, so.
They would, yeah, I don't know if they would.
Another place I have been to, they have these ones, so.
Any other questions? We have a roll call, please.
Trustee Greg Vickas?
Yes.
Trustee Dean Morelli?
Yes.
Trustee Karen Johnson?
Yes.
Trustee Denise Salvino?
Yes.
Supervisor Alberico?
Yes. Okay, motion carries. Next item we have is the oldest elevator contract. This one bugs the heck out of it, guys. Oldest elevator, we had a 5-year contract, it's coming up to the end of the 5-year contract. Comes out to be about $100 a month for this contract. I don't see what they do for this contract, any time they come and look at anything, they charge us. But, they talk to them, basically they say, I think the word for it, the state statute says we have to have a contract to give away. So we have to have contracts. So I looked into other elevator companies, closest ones in Missouri. So this is basically, we have to do it, guys. So I want you guys to be aware that, I think it's, I don't want to say a scam. It is what it is. We have to do it. So, entertain a motion to accept the contract from Mumbles.
I'll make a motion to approve the Mumbles contract.
Make a motion by Greg Pickens.
I'll second.
Second by Denise Salvino. Any questions?
Well, it's a once a month.
I think they were three or four
a year.
I think it's three or four.
It was over the third quarter.
No, I'm aware that all is pretty much a month.
And if you do a 5-year contract, they give us 3% off or something like that. Anyway, any other questions? We have a roll call, please.
Supervisor Alberico?
Yes.
Trustee Dean Morelli?
Yes.
Trustee Greg Vickas?
Yes.
Trustee Karen Johnson?
Yes.
Trustee Denise Salvino?
Yes.
Okay, motion carries. Okay, furniture. We discussed having a new furniture throughout the building. We bought the building, we didn't get all the windows, we built all the old stuff. And some of that furniture is 20 inside of the old, only yet. So we did get a package put together Hendrickson for the furniture that we think we would like. We have all the pins. $39,321.66.
Is that all their proposals?
This is one of those companies that is over $20,000. That's the that pre-bid company. They were $2,000 bid. They were back. And then we don't do this, then we have to just pay for it. That's the process. So that's what this is.
I'm just on clear on that. Gary, I mean, is that the situation here where like Henry said, approved by what the fuel iron or township or how?
I'm not even exactly sure. I think maybe you know.
We might not have.
John would probably say it best.
State bid contract. Yeah, it's basically free bid. Set price or. He's wrong on a candidate, but. But anyway, it's set by the state.
Accepted by the state, so we don't have to.
And it's like certain companies are part of that or. This one, you know, it's. Because my next question would be, obviously all the office holders, they looked at it and they all pretty much.
I'll be honest with you. I'm not a furniture person. I've been a painter and I said I'm not going to fuck. I don't care. But I did ask our assessor and Eric, the clerk, pretty much to help pick out everything.
We spent quite a bit of time with Raleigh. He came in and showed us all the samples and he went over everything. Mary Ann was familiar and he looked at some of the stuff that she had as well. She's got wonderful stuff and it's held up very well.
This is the same company that did the furniture for the assessor's office. 2 years ago or a year and a half ago. So everything in the assessor's office came through the same company.
And basically, most of this furniture, I know I go look at it all, it's kind of hard to figure it out. It's basically benches in front of the main lobby, upstairs, some chairs by the assessor's office, and the chairs over there. I think there's some chairs out by you now that will all match and be nice. It'll be a conference table in my office. My office will be some things.
It's a really nice update.
Yeah, I was trying to pull up pictures online. I don't know if somebody wanted to get them, but it's hard to see.
We have booklets. Michelle has booklets. She has booklets, and we have sample swatches.
Well, I guess, like I said, everybody's kind of the office holders, whatever.
We're very involved, yeah.
Well, I pretty much. I'm not real big with that shit and stuff.
I'm just wondering, like, the Veterans Affairs office, anything so close to the planning, if we do that, do they have furniture in that office now, or would you need furniture?
Well, if we approve the veterans, they will bring their own medicine and stuff in at the office.
That's not normal for at all, because usually the townships that we go into or where veteran affairs are at located, those townships already have available office that's there for them to utilize, because the majority of office buildings are uniform. You know, so that's already, they already have furniture in there. But say, for instance, if we need an additional secure cabinet, stuff like that, then yes, we'll get it from Springfield or chairs or what have you. But
do we have that?
Right, it's just stuff that you guys have here.
To get you known, you probably
yeah.
Have
some.
Oh,
yeah. Give me a budget and a deficit.
If we approve this tonight, I'm sure the furniture will be a few months before it gets here or whatever. But after that, I'll be asking for surplus and all the little stuff. We'll be plenty of desks.
Yes.
We already have one of the addresses. I don't think that's much.
Okay.
Any other questions? I don't think I have a motion yet. What?
I make a motion to approve the purchase of the office for the veterans.
All right. I have a motion right there for this.
I'll second it.
And by Karen Johnson. Any other questions? Have a roll call, please.
Trustee Denise Salvino?
Yes.
Trustee Greg Vickis?
Yes.
Trustee Karen Johnson?
Yes.
Trustee Dean Morelli?
Yes.
Supervisor Alvarico?
Yes. All right. Now we get down to the end of the building here, but I have one more thing. The veterans, VA and East. We have here tonight Anthony Hernandez. Do you want to get say a little bit before we make a motion?
Evening, everybody. My name is Anthony Hernandez. I'm a veteran service officer that works for the Illinois Department of Veterans Affairs. I've been at this position going out 5 years now. Prior to four, I was in the Navy for 24 years. I retired out of the Pentagon as a chief legal counsel. Apparently, chief paralegal to legal counsel to Chairman Joint Chiefs. From there, I picked up my first retirement job was working for vets. It's the entry for people going into service. So, as administrator for doing that office, and then I got picked up from the state to become a veteran service officer, and which I'm also a credit from the Department of Veterans Affairs as a veteran service officer. Prior to here, I was located at the Forest Park location, just outside of Cicero. When I moved to Lockport, I shifted my office to the Forest Park location. When the Forest Park closed down, I was officeless for a while. And thanks to Ron, he came to him and asked if he needed a veteran service officer for Lockport veterans, and he said yes. Any questions?
I did have Gary put together contract. Just a boilerplate contract that we say when we get the pantry. Actually, I did send it over to the veterans and they already signed it. So basically, we do this tonight. I'll sign it and get it notarized tomorrow, and we'll be all set. So,
I'll make a motion to approve this for the veterans officer.
And I will second that motion.
Motion by Greg and second by Denise. Any other questions before we vote? Hearing none, have a roll call, please.
Trustee Denise Salvino?
Yes.
Trustee Greg Vickis?
Yes.
Trustee Dean Morelli?
Yes.
Trustee Karen Johnson?
Yes.
Supervisor Alvarico?
Yes. All right. Looking forward to having you move in. Start cleaning up that office tomorrow. Okay, moving on to new business. First one on the list, donation to the Will County Community Service. We don't have to vote on it. That was a mistake on my part in the office, but we had approval of the agenda together. As you, when you approved the budget originally, we approved the line item for Will County Community Concerns, and that is in general assistance. And you notice on the bill list today, we didn't have that money on that bill list that we approved. So I'll be sending that check. So, we got that, like I said, just miscommunication in the office. We didn't Okay, next on the agenda is there's a boot camp, a virtual boot camp. I know a few of the trustees in the clerk's office have shown an interest in attending this Zoom meeting, but it is open-ended. So if anybody else wants to go, I'm going to send this registration in by Friday. So if you guys want to just go, it's a Zoom meeting, you can go to home or your office or whatever. But please let me know by Friday so I can, if it's cheaper to go for 400 for everybody, or $50 each, so please let me know by Friday, and I'll get that sent in. I don't want to deny people that really want to go, not go because I'm waiting for minutes. Just text me or better yet, text the office, share. She's the one that's going to be sending this in. But I do need a motion to approve it, yes.
I'd like a motion to approve registration for the training course.
I have a motion to approve the training.
I'll second it.
A Any other questions? Are you done? Member roll call.
Supervisor Alberico.
Yes.
Trustee Dean Morelli.
Yes.
Trustee Greg Vickas.
Yes.
Trustee Karen Johnson.
Yes.
Trustee Denise Salvino.
Yes.
All right. Again, no. Really trying to let me know by Friday. Okay, I did have a letter sent from the, I believe it's from the police department, one of the sponsors of this torch. I guess it's kind of like a demolition derby, the way I understand it.
Yes.
And I have no problem supporting our local police department, so I think we're going to be getting a really talk about this early in our special meeting to be on there. So I will entertain a motion to.
I'll make a motion to approve the donation for $200.
$200, that's what I'm saying. I got a motion.
I'll second that.
Ready? A second. Denise?
So I just wanted to mention that the money from this does go to support. None of the money goes to the police department, it all goes to support special projects. So that's what the, proceeds from the police department is actually generating part of this. And they're sponsoring, we're actually sponsoring the part of the police department, but the proceeds from the inquiries are going to special projects.
Which special projects has a lot of.
Right.
That's what I mean. Any questions before I take a roll call? Member roll call, please.
Trustee Dean Morelli.
Yes.
Trustee Greg Vickas.
Yes.
Supervisor Alberico.
Yes.
Trustee Karen Johnson.
Yes.
Trustee Denise Salvino.
Yes.
Motion carries. Next is again, it's another sponsorship. This is for the Legacy Ranch, which is about 2 doors down from us on the Farrell Road here. They basically, it's horseback riding. Again, this is for Special Olympics. This is their show that they do, I believe it's in October. And they asked us to do this sponsor them. And I'll let you guys decide if we want to sponsor this or not. I would say a grand sponsor of 250 or a silver sponsor of 500.
I can tell you a little bit about it.
Okay. Yes.
It's physical disabilities, both cognitive and physical disabilities, and then we have assisted riding lessons. So before they can compete in the Special Olympics, they do have to complete 2 shows. Prior to that, so there's different things that they have going on, and the sponsorships are involved here, but it's going towards these 4 shows to help them get to the Special Olympics is from what I understood when they came in.
And I did reach out to them and kind of report back that most of the people that attend there are Lockport Township residents.
Yes, and they are our neighbors right here.
Yeah, I know they're right here, but I'm just like, I want to make sure.
Right.
Now, it's home to show.
And their show coming up is, the one show is in New Lenox. It's before the show that they're speaking of that's going to be right here.
I think they chose this one because they do use our parking lot also. So I would entertain a motion to sponsor a bronze medal sponsor.
I made a motion. We make a donation to Secrete or whatever.
Very beneficial.
I agree. I work with another branch that's right here on Bruce Road. It's see the kids firsthand, don't go to take bribes, bunch of friends, their children, take advantage of it. And that's what they talk about all week, people are going, they're so excited to go through this. It really is a sort of attitude.
Who made the motion, Sam?
I'll make the motion for $500.
I'll second it.
Motion by Greg, second by Denise. Any other questions on this? We have a roll call, please.
Trustee Denise Salvino?
Yes.
Trustee Karen Johnson?
Yes.
Supervisor Alvarico?
Yes.
Trustee Dean Morelli?
Yes.
Trustee Greg Mikus?
Yes.
Motion carries. We also voted tonight, well, only a couple other things that I didn't receive in the mail and I plan to bring up. Received from Will County, this is land use, I have two cases here for, let's see, one is at 17247 West 143rd Street in Lockport. They're asking for variance for their lot frontage from 150 to 86 feet. And a variance of a minimum side yard setback from 10 feet to 5 and 5.7 feet west. They are going to be having a public hearing on this. A scheduled public hearing will be August 3rd, 2021 at 6:30 at the Will County Office Building, 302 North Chicago Street, second floor, courtroom, Joliet. If you have any questions or comments, please do not hesitate to contact via email or at 815-774-3367. Second one is, the address is 14357 High Road. And this variance is for maximum accessory building area from 1,800 square feet to 2,569 square feet. There again, they're going to have a public hearing on that, and it's the same time, August 3rd. And one of the 6:30 is in the building, 302 North State Street, second floor boardroom. If you have any questions, I'll just give you an email or call 815-774-3367. All right. Thank you for your patience. We did a lot of work tonight.